And welcome to Live in the Hive, the only online magazine show dedicated to theatre across Greater Manchester. I'm Michelle Eagleton. I'm with you for the next half an hour, and have we got a show in store for you? Yes, and tonight's show, we have got two brand new musicals currently touring the UK and wowing audiences. Firstly, we have got Identical, the leading producer of that show, Kenny Wax, is going to be joining me here to tell us all the lowdown on what we can expect. And it sounds absolutely fantastic. Now, alongside that, we've got a musical called The Osmonds. Yes, it is based on that superstar family. It's currently been on at the Palace Theatre here in Manchester, and the crowds have been loving it. Now, the cast are going to be joining me to tell me what it's like playing an Osmonds. And as you can see from our banner down below, they're even going to be playing us out of the show with a fantastic song. Now, if that wasn't enough, every week we bring you this Greater Manchester Theatre news. And this week we have got some brilliant shows for you to watch out for. Oh, it's very exciting. It is very warm as well. Temperatures are soaring this Sunday night, and they're about to soar even more as I introduce you to some of the cast of The Osmonds. Take a look at this. Now, I feel quite giddy, all right, because I'm actually with a boy band here. Yeah. Honestly, it's like, and you actually reenact the whole kind of thing. You are like a boy band. You've just come up the stairs, and I'm like, there's
a
good air about you.
With the beat
at
One Direction.
Yeah, yeah. I think it's funny because, you know, we're playing a group of brothers, and I think we spent so much time with each other that you end up being like brothers, and you know, we fight, we argue, we cuddle, we kiss.
And it looks like you're having an absolute ball on this tour, right?
Yeah, we are. Again, we're so grateful to have us five lads. Like, we're so, the first, like, first time we met was in just like an audition room. We just like singing through Love Me For A Reason. We just all went straight away.
Yeah. I think you could tell straight away that there was a bond between us that, you know, and we built that so quickly, and that helps in the show because we have to play brothers who, you know, so it's we're very lucky, as you said, to be in this five that we are.
And you know, there is quite a resemblance. I know the casting must have been really good because you're Johnny, all right? You're Alan, and you're Wayne, aren't you? Oh, fantastic. Now, have you really studied the original Osmonds then? Is that what was part of the process?
Parts of it. Like, I think, I don't know about you boys, but I did a lot of like watching videos on YouTube and things, listening to the albums, just trying to find the sound, the way they moved. Yeah. And then also having Jay in the room, just asking Jay, like, what is it like? What, how would they move? How would they sound? What would they say? What would they think? Things like that really helped having him there.
Yeah, that's really good. But I mean, the pressure must have been on when you did that audition, and like the real Jay Osmond was there in the room. Thank God you weren't going for the part.
We're all right. But I think it was, I think, you know, it was just so good. Suddenly, when we get into that first rehearsal, and you've got Jay, and you can ask him questions, and because the fans want to see the mannerisms as well as anything, they want us to be as real as we can be. So I think we from learning from Jay. I mean, who better to learn from than someone who was there and who did it and who knows them better than anybody else does?
So, yeah. And this is a brand new musical, so that must be really great as a performer to think, do you know what? We've created the role first.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. And what's so great about it is things are constantly changing. Like, things are, little tweaks are happening, and we're allowed a bit more creative freedom. And like I said, because we're creating the roles, we're the ones that went, okay, I want to stand here on stage, so I'm going to do this. I want to do this with my arm. And the director would be like, yeah, that's great, you know? So we've been allowed that creative freedom, which has been really fun to do, hasn't it? So,
that is
brilliant.
Now, I'm going to really annoy these guys because, obviously, you know, everyone's going crazy.
So right, oh, shall we go?
See ya. It's not about Eleanor, it's the real Osmonds here, of course.
Same at stage door. He's coming out.
He's coming in a minute. Well, yeah.
Don't take the photo for us.
Yeah. You must be a Wayne fan, though, because you're wearing orange.
So. Of course. Yeah. I didn't want to say that, alright? But what must that be like? Do you get a lot of screams?
Yeah, I didn't really anticipate what it was actually going to be like. And especially doing Puppy Love, like, for the first time, I didn't realise. They are literally, like, 16-year-olds at a gig. At the first time they would have seen Donny Osmond. It is crazy. We have had, knickers thrown. We've had
people on stage,
ladies lying on the stage.
I don't think we dare pick them up. we didn't want to check.
No. But yeah, ladies jump on stage. Like, it's been absolutely crazy. So I'm so grateful.
And it's kind of ladies of a certain age as well, really, isn't it?
It's no one our age. We're all like,
But like, I always think it's like, nowadays you can, if anyone wanted to go see their favourite band, they could get it on YouTube and just watch it straight away on the train. But like, back in the day, they had to buy a ticket to go see these people. And now you have to buy a ticket to see this musical. And it's like, it's exactly the same. Like, you have to buy a ticket to come see this. And I think that's why it's so magical for that generation. Because they had to buy a ticket, they had to travel and go. They couldn't just go, okay,
beep, beep. Oh, and they did as well. Yeah, like, proper, like, with groupies around, kind of like going here, there, and everywhere. Yeah. I'm going to put you on the spot as well. And not that I'm not going to put you too. No. Favourite part in the show, then, if I had to, because it's been running now for a bit. And, you know, when I sit there and watch it in Manchester, I'll be like, ooh, that's a bit that they like. I mean, it's obviously, you like all of it, but. Go on.
I reckon it's the end because it means I can go and have a rest afterwards. No, I think I would.
Like the way that you think.
I would say the end though, because I think we get on. Now it's changed a little bit, but we get to the end and there's the five of us all singing "He's My Brother," and it's a special moment. You've just sung "Love Me for a Reason." You've got the audience have well, hopefully loved it, and we stand there and it's really lovely for us to be just the five of us on stage and just sing a song without anything else. You're just there, the music. And it's quite special every
night.
It's
the arc of the story.
Yeah,
it's like the end of everyone's seen everything. It's like, woof. Yeah.
Everyone's come back together, and it's just, for me, that's the strongest moment.
Oh, those boys are absolutely lovely. And we're going to have more from the rest of the Osmonds cast a little bit later on in the show. So do stay tuned for that. And of course, the boys are going to be singing us out later on with "Love Me for a Reason." What a classic. Now, of course, every week we like to bring you what's going on in Greater Manchester when it comes to theatre. And this week, of course, we have got no different for you. Yes, it is time for this Greater Manchester Theatre News. Now, what has been going on this week in our city? Has there been any announcements that have been made? Well, there have been quite a few, actually. Now, firstly, we're going to go a little bit further afield because recently you may have seen in the news the Shakespeare North Playhouse has opened in Prescott. It is an absolutely fantastic venue, really doing some amazing things which are going to be coming to the Northwest. And one of the first ones is A Midsummer Night's Dream, the Shakespeare classic coming to Shakespeare North Playhouse, but mixed up for the 21st century. You can see singer-songwriter there, Nadine Shah. This is her debut performance in the show as Titania. She is going to be absolutely incredible in this role. And alongside her, you have got BAFTA award-winning actor David Morrissey. His voice is going to be Oberon, and that is running from the 22nd of September to the 22nd of October. So a really good run there at Shakespeare North Playhouse in Prescott. Definitely worth the journey down there to go and check that one out. A little bit closer to home, I'm very excited about this one. We first look at some production shots from Unfortunate, the untold story of Ursula the Sea Witch. And of course, we're talking about the Little Mermaid here, the villain of the piece. And this is her take on that tale that we know from Disney, but you know, it's not Disney, it's not really for kids, it is more of an adult production, this one, and very much, I would imagine, in the vein of Wicked. It's going to change your perception of Ursula for good. And that's on from the 6th to the 10th of September at the Lowry. And something else to look forward to that's coming to the Lowry very soon is the award-winning show Girl from the North Country. This has been wowing audiences. It's been a real hit on Broadway, had so many nominations and awards already. It features the music and lyrics of Bob Dylan. And if I could choose one to watch or put on somebody's list, I think that is definitely one to put there, from the 20th to the 24th of September. A really short run there, so you know, you'll have to be quick to get a ticket, but so many exciting things are coming our way, and Manchester is just a hot bed of some brilliant theatre productions. Now, talking about brilliant theatre productions coming our way, there's a brand new musical in town. It's called Identical. It's based on the book The Parent Trap, and I got to speak to the producer behind it, Kenny Wax. And of course, the first thing that I had to ask him, when it takes 9 years for a production like this to get to the stage, what is it like when it finally opens?
A relief, to be honest, because it's been quite a big undertaking. I probably read something about it, but we've got, so in Nottingham, we've got 35 local children in two teams. And then we brought 8 children, 2 teams of 4 up from London, plus 3 sets of completely identical twins from London and a dog who we hire. So they say, you know, in theatre, never worked with children or animals, and we've done spectacularly the two things together.
Do you like a big challenge, Kenny? Is that what it's all about?
I just literally fell in love with this idea, Michelle, 9 years ago. It was the agents of the author, who is sadly no longer with us, called Eric Kastner, who survived the Second World War, was interviewed and interrogated by the Gestapo many times because he was seen as very anti-German, because he was writing these books about kind of children and family and goodness. So he wrote all the Emil and the detective books, for instance.
Oh.
Very, very kind of famous set of books about this young child detective who's doing good, kind of almost a forerunner to the Marvel movies, maybe. But The Parent Trap, which was originally called Lottie and Lisa in German, was a show again about the kind of coming together of a family who'd been separated, and it was felt very much that this was his way of reflecting the fact that Germany had been so fractured during the war. None of this is in the show, by the way. I don't want to be too heavy-handed, but the story of The Parent Trap is one about the healing of a family that's been separated, and two children bringing the kind of parents back together. And I just love the idea of putting identical twins on stage for whom you couldn't tell the difference.
You said, though, there is emotion at the heart of this, and lots of the reviews that I've read really say that is so apparent in this, that it's really captured that sense. Does that make you feel really happy that you've achieved that, Kenny?
When you say achieved it, you didn't kind of set out. I mean, actually, on the first day of rehearsal, the director, Sir Trevor Nunn, did say that if we could get the audiences by the end of the show to be literally laughing and crying, then we had set out our objective, but it's really a product of the story that we tell. And there are quite a few moments in particularly Act Two where you really do feel the tears welling up in your eyes. Is it deeply moving? That's actually a Guardian quote, deeply moving, it said in the review. It's a deeply moving story. And when you know, as I do, how much work the kids have put into it, particularly the identical twins, who carry the weight of the whole show on their shoulders, by the time they kind of do come back together at the end, and then you get the joy of the curtain call, I mean, literally the audience are just in floods of tears, because it is a really kind of unusual story and told in a very spectacular and theatrical way by people who really are, you know, at the very top of their game. The directors, the designers, the choreographers, a fantastic team of West End pros who've done Broadway and the West End and, you know, had many hits. I mean, Trevor Nunn is, Les Miserables are probably the world's biggest, most successful show ever, but also Cats, which ran for 25 years in the West End, Starlight Express, Sunset Boulevard, you know, really just shows that around the world have made people, you know, kind of laugh and cry. And also, I think, made many people interested in the theatre. Some people have probably, you know, perhaps never been to a show before they saw Starlight Express when they're 8, 9 or 10, or perhaps Les Mis when they were a bit older.
Yeah, I mean, God, you have got a stellar amount of people around you. I was going to say, Trevor Nunn, unbelievable. Going back to kind of the casting process, though, of finding these twins, what was that like for you guys as kind of the panel, really getting the right fit? And also, it is tricky to get, I would imagine it's quite tricky to get talented twins, right? Or is there a lot of them about?
Yeah, very tricky. I mean, it wasn't really a panel originally. When we first decided to do this show, it could only be achievable if we knew there were identical twins out there who could pull it off, quite frankly. And therefore, when we did our first casting session for identical twins, which was probably about 4 or 5 years ago, we had about 50 pairs who came to see us on that first day. It was incredible just to see 50 pairs of identical twins. And what stupidly I hadn't realized is they would all be dressed in their identical twin pairing. I don't know why I hadn't, because we asked them to come as identical twins, but you know, they all wore the matching outfits. Well, of course they would. You've asked them to come, but I just wasn't kind of particularly expecting that for some reason. And it was probably from that first day that I thought there's real talent here. You know, it's not going to be for everybody. There were some people that were great little actresses that maybe couldn't sing, or terrific singers, but were a little bit wooden. But, you know, we're talking about kids that were 8, 9, and 10 years old. But we really, really did tremendously well over the period of time to get, in the end, we've ended up with 3 pairs, which we felt we needed for our kind of 6 or 7 week run. And they're all different. We've got one pair come from over from Ireland, 2 pairs from around the London area, broadly around the London area, but they're just all taking it on with such incredible skill and like professionalism, really extraordinary for kids so young. And that's another thing that just gets you at the end of the show, when you know that literally the weight of this big multi-million pound musical has been on their shoulders, and they've pulled it off, and they've literally convinced you, and they've literally done a swap on stage, and they've gone back to their different parents who they didn't know in the story that we tell. And you know, the whole thing is just so convincing.
I think, you know, hearing you talk so passionately, it really does make me think to myself, you have this knack, Kenny, that you can see something in a production that knows it's going to be a hit. You just have this talent. I mean, you've been described as the best in the business before now. How does it feel to be able to kind of know that and see that in a show and then have the hit?
Sometimes when people say, what do you do for a living? If I'm not wanting to put all my cards on the table, I could say, it would sound a little bit sick, but I could say I'm a professional gambler. Because actually, rather than knowing that everything will be a hit, that is what we do. Every single show that we do, new show, is a different production company, sometimes with different investors and different creatives and a different cast. It's its own business on its own. And if it doesn't work, and not all of them work, then that business, you know, gets put to the side and we go on to the next thing. So as you get more and more experience, and I've been doing this now for about 30 years, you do get better, inevitably. You get wiser. You get to work with grander people. We mentioned Sir Trevor Nunn, but his whole team have been amazing. And 30 years ago, that's not a team that I could have possibly put together. But as you deal with, you know, more experienced people, and you can choose the right theatres to put the show into, and you have bigger budgets, and you can raise the money, and it does all kind of fit into place. And then ultimately, it's about, you know, have I chosen the right show? Because although the director and the choreographer, they stage the show, they put it on, I have to employ the book writer and the composer and the lyricist, and then indeed the directors and the designers and the choreographers. So I kind of sit at the top of the business. But everybody has their own huge and very specific role. And then the whole team has to kind of come together as one. Because sometimes you have a show which is kind of beautifully designed, or, you know, is a great story or a wonderful central performance, but all the other elements don't necessarily come together. But in something like Les Mis, as an example, that we mentioned before, that is when all those people are pulling together in the same direction for the same aim. And so the design works with the costume design, works with the orchestrations and the grandeur and the direction. You know what I mean? It all comes together. And that's ultimately when you get the alchemy of a kind of a perfect production, which we hope we're close to. Inevitably, this is a tryout production, Nottingham into Manchester. We'll probably make a few little tweaks if we get a West End theatre, which we're hoping to get for sometime next year. So I'd say to all of your viewers, come and see it now before it goes into the West End, and then come and see it again in the West End. But, you know, support your local theatre. It's been a a terrible 2 or 3 years. We've wanted to put that behind us, and this is a show that really is so kind of filled with love and joy that I think it really can help us kind of move on with our lives in a very kind of happy way.
Oh, I totally agree there with Kenny. This is one show that we really need right now, and it will be so heartwarming. And I cannot wait for that to come to the Lowry. It's going to be absolutely fantastic. Now, talking of fantastic shows that I have seen recently, I went to the Palace Theatre this week to check out the Osmonds Musical, and it didn't disappoint at all. It was absolutely brilliant. The crowd went wild. Jay Osmond was there himself and got on stage at the end to sing Crazy Horses. But now it's time to take a look at the guy who plays Jay in the show, and also the performer who plays Merrill, and find out what it is like to be an Osmond. Now we've talked to the other boys, and it does seem like you're having so much fun. I know, sorry, you were first on, guys, you know. how are you enjoying the tour of the Osmonds, the musical?
It's great. It's great. We are having such a laugh. It's hard. Our voices and our knees don't like us very much. But no, it's so fulfilling. It's so rewarding. And I think we're kind of enjoying like a once in a career experience really on this show, like creating something brand new in its very first iteration. A lot of the times, you know, you can join a show in a cast change, or it's a big production that's come over from America and you're an original cast, but the show already exists. Mm-hmm. Whereas this is totally new. I mean, things are changing even now, kind of 3-4 months in. We're still getting new script edits, and we're going to change that number, and we're going to do this bit here and that bit there. So it's having that experience every day. I think we were discussing the other day, never felt like ownership over your work like it.
So it keeps you on your toes, doesn't it, really?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, I was quite daunted at first. I was so scared to do it.
I mean, it's a super group, isn't it? These guys were, like, massive, and they still are. Yeah. Still playing over in Vegas, you know, Donnie.
And the stuff you've got to sing every night as well is ridiculous. Ryan won't say this because he's very humble. His voice is absolutely incredible, and singing what Merrill actually used to sing in the keys Merrill used to sing, how you do that, I still don't know.
Thank you. don't need makeup for this. I just felt so daunted, but I started it, and honestly, I'm not just saying it, our team was so, made us feel so comfortable. And we came in, and because it was straight after like COVID, I hadn't sung for ages, so I was like really worried, like, what am I gonna sound like? And it was like, we've always been treated like people when we started this, and that's quite like a touching thing to have, like you're not just a robot that just has to come on and sing. And I think that's kind of maybe what people witness on in this show, is that we're all people that actually get on with each other.
And it's a personal show, isn't it, because this is kind of something that's been created by an actual Osmond, Jay Osmond. So I feel it needs to kind of get that balance right, doesn't it? Did they all go wild with Crazy Horses, though? I've got to say, that must be a moment on stage, yeah?
The intro starts, and because we've made them wait for it, haven't we? They've sat through the rest of the show.
Oh, you tease them, that's it.
And we tease it out of them, and then that intro starts, and you can feel, it's almost like a sense of relief that they've finally got the moment they want, and you just hear the screaming, you know, and the...
There was a person the other day, sat like this, the whole way through, just... watching the show like this, at the end, legs going, arms up in the air, brilliant.
That is when you know that you've done an absolutely brilliant job, okay, you know. And you've been in this from the start, because you were in the workshops as well.
Yeah, it's been about nearly 3.5 years now, I think, that I've been attached to it.
Oh my God, you're living the Osmond life.
Yeah, I feel like I'll never get away from it. This will be with me forever
now.
It's absolutely incredible to kind of think of the journey we've been on, especially now we've made it to Manchester, and this is kind of like our big launch, you know, we're here and the show's kind of fully realised now. But going back to the initial reading before we even did the workshop, of just reading this script the first time, just got two writers, Sean and Julian, that have written it with Jay, load of people sat in a room, let's just read it out loud for the first time and see what we've got. And for me, it immediately leapt off the page. I
at the moment I kind of read that, I made it very clear to everyone involved, like, if this show ever happens, I want to be there, because this is amazing.
The thing is, you had that instant kind of reaction, but I spoke to Jay, right, the real Jay, and he said as soon as you walked in the room, he just knew that you were him. I think that must be an amazing thing to feel.
Yeah, he's an incredible man, and he's been so generous with me, with his time, with his advice, with his notes about certain things, and kind of creating this together. It feels like it's been like a joint effort, because every night is a responsibility. You're representing not only the family as we do, but you're representing that specific person who's bearing their soul on stage, kind of through me. But there are times and bits of their story that I'm sure are not very pleasant to relive every night when you're watching your life play out. So kind of entrusting that to me, I feel this, again, a great weight of responsibility even at every single performance to do it justice. But I'll never, I think, fully be able to express how grateful I am for the level of trust that he's kind of put in me with that.
Are you grateful for the clothes though?
The tight fit in white jumpsuit, do you mean?
Yeah, and
were the scarves involved? Do we see all the scarves?
Oh.
They love the scarves.
Audience. In the audience.
Oh, in the audience. Oh my god.
Oh, actually, yes, we do have a scarf at the end. Yeah. We do, but in our colours.
But the way they're like bringing out their vintage Osmond merchandise that they've had for nearly like 50 years, and they keep it and they bring it along to the show, and the moment things like Puppy Love start, then Love Me For A Reason starts, when Crazy Horses start, you just see that, and they're there, and they're transported back to a time that, well, I guess it was a simpler time again in the world politically, and we've got the benefit of hindsight of history over 50 years, but to see them relive a very short moment in their lives, and they're probably in that 15, 16 year old age, just loving these boys, to just recreate a small iota of that every day is amazing.
Oh, you're making a lot of women very happy. I think the women in Manchester are going to love you. I can't promise no knickers being thrown at you, because I've heard...
We've had it.
We've had that.
We've had a woman climb on stage.
That was
in Dublin.
Did you?
I absolutely and just Alex broke up. I was just like, what are you doing?
I hope she was fully clothed.
Yes.
She was just, but I think we'd given another 2 minutes. I don't know what would have happened after that.
Oh, brilliant. I am going to really enjoy that. I'm going to be watching for every woman's reaction. Don't worry, you won't get anything like that from me. I'll just be whooping and hollering. Is that okay?
I think that'll suffice. I'm sure that'll be enough.
I might actually bring a banner. I mean, you know, let's see what I can get away with.
Do
Ryan and Alex.
Hey, just don't tell the boys.
No, we won't.
Well, I didn't throw my knickers and I didn't make a banner, but I did cheer those guys from start to finish. They were absolutely brilliant. The performance was amazing and the musical was a real hit. Now, if you don't believe me, I am bringing a little bit of the Osmonds musical to you right now. So I'm going to play you out the show with the five guys from the Osmonds the musical, with, of course, an Osmond classic. You can't not love this song. It is Love Me For A Reason. Enjoy, and I'll see you next Sunday.
because it's only messing with my pride.